All right, day one at the Expo Hall is complete. The working class nerds are sitting here at a bar in our hotel.
Oh, yeah.
To the left of me, Nick is. To the right of me, A-Trax, Mr. West Coast is here.
No, that's Mr. Mojito.
Mr. Mojito.
Mr. Mojito. So,
in March in Boston.
Can I get a How Now Brown Cow?
How Now Brown Cow.
How Now Brown Cow. You gotta be louder.
Yeah.
I do?
Yeah.
Oh.
You wanna be in the...
I hate being louder.
I know.
I'll just get closer to the microphone.
There you go.
So,
I'll look like
day one impressions. Oh, perfect. You know, A-Trax, want to switch seats because you're eating the...
That makes sense.
Yeah. I can sit at the end.
Huh? I said I'm also quieter. Yeah.
So, like I was saying...
We're keeping all this in.
We are, yeah. It's just going to record. There's plenty of space. So... What I was saying is, your day one thoughts?
Left to right?
So, I think I said this earlier, but I really enjoyed first the... these are so hot. I really enjoyed first the... which was the first game we played? Dead Island 2. That was awesome. It was really cool. I can see myself getting into that game. With the exploration and, like, the fighting mechanics and stuff, that seemed fun.
Yeah.
And also, the later, the Peaky Blinders VR game was wicked cool. Like, that was immersion on another level that I've never experienced before. That was epic.
Right.
And I've also never played a VR game, so not a real one like that. What do you think?
I agree with you. Dead Island 2 was the perfect start.
Yeah.
To give... all the people at home a idea. I flew in from Portland yesterday. So I got to the Portland airport about 6:15 p.m. And I arrived here in Boston 7:45, which would be like 4:45 a.m. the next day. So Marcus and Nick picked me up. We went pretty much straight to PAX. We dropped the car off at the hotel and went straight to PAX.
Mm-hmm.
Walking into the convention center and seeing all that stuff was so, so cool.
Oh, yeah. It's like surreal. I mean, you're like, oh my God, there's games everywhere.
Well, and, yeah. You know, and something else about it is, so I've been where it's been way more packed with games.
Yeah.
But it almost felt today, like Thursday felt so good because there wasn't so many people there.
Yeah.
That, like, you could walk around and talk to people, and now we've established some of the games that we've played.
Which we know what we want to go back to or whatever.
Well, and they are going to recognize us.
Right.
You know, I did like Dead Island 2. I liked how they brought the RPG really to it. And it wasn't just hack and slash, because you couldn't just kill those zombies. That was not easy at all.
No.
By the way, also, because we're media, we got in, like, when we're playing Dead Island, they were announcing PAX opens in 15 minutes.
Right, because they let the media in an hour early on today.
Right. So, I didn't even know that. And the guy said I was the second person to actually beat the demo.
Right.
And that made me feel pretty good as a gamer, just to be like, I'm one of the first people to beat the demo for this long-awaited game.
Yeah.
You know, and hopefully they release it publicly so all of you at home can play it. It was really cool. A theme park vibe to it. You start off on the beach and you walk into the pier and just hack and slash.
Well,
and that was
too,
that was awesome.
Is they gave you, like, the demo was good because they gave you an arsenal of weapons.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
They didn't give you, like, two. They gave you, like, it essentially felt like you were dropped in the middle of the game. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, there was, you know, I had an axe with, a torch applied to it. I had a pipe wrench with spikes coming out of it.
Electricity claws.
Electricity claws, like Wolverine.
A couple guns.
Oh, I only saw one gun.
An AR and a revolver.
A revolver. It was like number 8.
It was a revolver. So basically, in the demo, they gave you the arsenal so you can play the way you want.
Yeah, you could try it out. Although
like,
I
had a rake. I had a rake, and I was like, I'm not using a rake.
Yeah.
So the only...
I ended up finding a baseball bat for
it. Oh, see, that's sweet, too. I'm really curious to see the... like, what the game mechanics are in the beginning. Like, clearly, you're going to get, like, a stick to start. But it's... You're set in L.A., so is it going to be a complete open-world game?
The previous one was, wasn't it?
Well, it was.
I mean, you had missions.
You had missions.
But it was open-world. You could kind of go anywhere.
Kind of, like, but it was like a linear mission.
I just remember driving around in vehicles all over the place.
Hey, shout-out to Sovi for telling everybody at PAX East to have a great time.
Yeah. And everybody in the Discord.
Oh, yeah.
But, coming down and being able to play Dead Island before it was packed was great. And I think what I like about PAX, too, is the big, 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 big name titles, it just proves that there's not really a lot of AAA big name titles anymore.
Yeah.
Where, like, back in 2018... there were so many big name games being released, but not anymore.
And like there was a Blizzard booth, there was a Sony booth, there was a, you know what I mean? All those big publishers.
Well, E3 is really the place where those publishers go, right?
Not anymore.
Right.
They all pulled out.
Yeah.
Well, I guarantee it's expensive.
Yeah.
To have a booth.
Definitely. You gotta figure you're paying people, the staff to work it. You're paying some sort of giant fee to the conference.
Right.
For that spot.
Thought you didn't like shrimp.
I do.
I don't. I mean, I do, but I'm not.
I don't like the sauce, though.
You don't like the cocktail sauce?
I mean,
I don't either.
I don't like. Hate it, but I don't think it adds anything.
Oh my god, Julia.
I do like shrimp though.
You did a handstand on the bars.
Marcus is getting a call from his family.
I saw it.
That was amazing.
I'm saying for the viewers or for the listeners.
Oh, I forgot we're still recording.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah. So while Marcus talks to his family,
what else did you guys
I want to also say that. Shout out, and I know Marcus will want to talk about a lot of this too. At least for his personal experience. But shout out to all of those people who took time out of their day to explain. I mean, I know they're there for it.
Oh, really?
But a lot of people were super open to questions and super happy to, oh yeah, come try our game and what do you like? What don't you like? What do you think we could improve?
Right.
A lot of developers, or at least the people that were there, maybe they weren't developers,
really?
But the people that were there in charge of, you know, making this game public.
Already?
All those people were super helpful and knowledgeable,
right.
And open to criticism and how they could improve their game. So shout out to everybody we met with today.
Yeah.
Obviously, we can't name everybody.
Right.
I forget. But.
You know how cool that is?
I met a lot of cool people that were, like, really pumped to show off their game. It was cool.
Yeah. The WrestleQuest game was super exciting, too. I can't wait to show that to Stone.
Mm-hmm.
Right now?
A wrestling RPG.
Yeah, in, like, 16-bit or 32-bit, maybe?
Pixelated.
Pixelated art style, but it looked
pixel.
Good.
2D pixel art, but in traditional 2D pixel RPG fashion... All of the dialogue and everything is super over the top. And they got, I talked to, actually, we'll probably have some sound bites of it. But
right.
I talked to one of the, I don't know if he was a developer or if he was just a part of the company, but one of the company members talked to him and he said that a lot of the wrestlers, actually, they contacted their wrestler, like, real wrestlers like Randy Savage and the Andre the Giant Estate and all these different wrestlers that are in the game and asked for their likeness, and a ton of them were super helpful in, you know, just dealing with the legal side of it and helping them get be able to use the rights to different things. So I'm excited to see when that game comes out too.
Agreed.
I need to check again when that is, but yeah, shout out to the WrestleQuest people.
What'd you say?
All right.
So my initial thoughts here are that it was great to go. It was fun. The WrestleQuest was so much fun. Like, believe it or not, like, I liked it because the games I enjoyed today were super mellow.
Yeah. Marcus, you want another wing?
Don't have it. Eat it. I'm going to get something to eat.
No, I am too. I'm going to get a burger. Hey, Trex, you want this?
There were so many, like a lot of the games are not my style.
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? But I enjoyed playing them because they were mellow.
Yeah.
Like that WrestleQuest, I could see myself sitting back and playing it. But at the same time, it's like, I don't know if I could play that game for hours on it.
Yeah. It's too simple. But
well, it's not that it's simple. It's just that it's...
It's not your thing. It's a 2D pixel.
Well, no, it's not that. It's just slow moving.
Uh-huh.
And I feel like when streaming, you almost have... Like, I need it to be action-packed or I'll fall asleep.
You have to understand that it's the demo, too.
Oh, well, no, it's the real game. He said that this is, like, how it starts and how you build through your quest. And then they fast-forward a little bit to where you wrestle the boss, we'll call it. But...
Gotcha.
I did play Elden Ring today. I sat
we
down
have
and I
a
got
hilarious
it. What was actually
clip
awesome
that.
Was it was an Xbox 360 controller and it was like,
yeah,
home.
It was a legit Xbox 360 controller that they had plugged in. Not Xbox One.
Yeah.
Oh man, that was awesome.
It was.
The thumbsticks felt kind of like janky. I'm not going to lie.
Well, they're from 2007.
I know.
Yeah. They're five.
Well, no, they're cool, but...
The thing about, like, I don't know where they start. Where did they start me in Elden Ring?
You were pretty close to the beginning. Like, you were... For those who have played Elden Ring, he's still in Limgrave. He is where all of the warriors are encamped, just before the road where the troll drops down and all the archers are. Like,
did
literally right
troll?
In the beginning. Yeah. That's the clip that we
so
have.
So how do you
the
kill? How do you kill those archers? There's like seven archers shooting you.
You need your horse. Is the simple answer to that? You need your horse.
But there was no horse.
Well, they didn't have. Yes, that account didn't have the horse acquired. But in Elden Ring, there is a horse.
What are you getting, Nick?
I think a burger. I was oscillating between the burger and the chicken BLT.
Hand cut truffle fries.
Dude, that's what I was looking at, man. Those fries are sounding pretty good.
You know,
I'm gonna get some fries.
And then we played another game. What was the name of that game?
Bro, are you really gonna ask me the name of the game we played at PAX? That's so broad. First half of the day,
the
second
one
half
like
of the
Elden
day.
Ring, like minutes after.
Oh yes. Oh dude. Oh no.
So you dropped
this right here. It is.
Oh yeah.
Did you drop something?
I did. Okay.
Enotria, Enotria. The last song.
The guys were making fun of me because I never played a game like that.
Yeah. So Marcus described. So for reference, we went from the Intel booth where we were playing Elden Ring, and we walked over to Enotria, which is another Souls-like game.
And it was like in a booth with multiple games. There were so
right.
many different games.
It was an indie developer. It was a small game developer, and they were developing a Souls-like. And I started playing, and I thoroughly enjoyed myself. Marcus started playing and explained... I literally just started playing Elden Ring. Marcus, go.
Yeah, so I told the developer I just started playing Elden Ring 2 minutes ago. And he was like, what?
Why not? And his dad's a retired... Thank you.
What are you doing, Nick?
All down there? Or?
Yeah, thank you.
Are we ready for food or not?
Yeah.
No.
What beer did you get, Nick?
This is Stella.
Stella.
She's an issue, Lager.
Yeah, so the one thing I can say is I played Elden Ring and I want to play it.
Yeah, oh no, we'll download it tonight.
Yeah, because I want to try it, like, and go through the tutorial, but if I'm wasted, it's not going to be a good experience.
No.
Oh, no. Well, I mean, not for you, but for me, it would be great.
For me, it would be great.
Nick, you'd enjoy it, too.
Oh, yeah.
But there were some really cool games. I would say, for the most part, none of them were AAA.
Right.
Like, Dead Island 2 is a AAA game.
Yeah. Well, they had a THQ Nordic booth, but the only thing... Actually, we didn't really even go there.
They had
we
no did the Dead Island 2 devs there.
Right, which was weird.
Well, not when we went.
No, he said there's none here.
Oh.
So it was just staff. Yeah. They had the Home Wreckin'. What was that? Car Wreckin'? Yeah, it was called Home Wreckin'.
Wreckfest.
Wreckfest.
It was like the Wreckfest sequel.
Yeah, it was like a car racing game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I do want you to describe the Behemoth booth, because that is your...
So we went to the Behemoth booth. We had an appointment. We were a half an hour early, which the devs weren't there. Just their PR people were there. And so we were early. And they were super accommodating. They were super awesome. We got to chat with them for... Oh, my God, we were there 45 minutes.
Yeah.
At least, yeah.
And... They usually have this big, elaborate booth, but this year, I think, because their game isn't close to development, they did a small booth. And they had their, like, fake walls up where they store all their stuff, and they brought us into the back room where they had a pretty subpar monitor and a controller, but they were super accommodating, and we got to play their new game, Alien Hominid. It takes place 16 years after the original game, which you'll hear it. You'll hear it in the podcast because we have some sound bites from it. But I would say it's... it was fun. It will definitely be more fun when there's three of us playing it.
Definitely.
Or four of us rather than...
Just the one.
Yeah. For me, the Behemoth booth felt like the most... Oh, hey, come back here and play our game and, like, talk with us. You know, like Marcus said, the booths, maybe they had a larger space to be able to do that in the past. No, they didn't. But, like, the three of us, pretty much, they just said, here, like, fill in to our back room and play the game and, like, talk with us and just...
Well, something else that I liked is they had a pure press setup just for press people.
Yeah.
I appreciated that a lot.
Yep.
Because every other booth who... we had an appointment with, they just kind of were like, you gotta wait until somebody else is done.
Right.
Where in years past, I've seen people kick people off the systems.
Right.
To say, hey, we have a press meeting. They were super accommodating, super nice people. Honestly, the game of the day for me was the Peaky Blinders game.
Me too. Yeah.
Because I've never played a VR game before, and I got motion sick, but they were super nice to, like, walk me through it, like... I'm hoping tomorrow I get to play it again because I have a little more...
I definitely want to show Joey that.
Yeah, like I want to have a little bit more experience.
Yeah.
But I would say it's one of those games that you have to be there early because if you've never played VR...
It'll,
like,
have a line, too.
It's right. Going to have a huge line.
Yep.
I've watched Peaky Blinders like the first five episodes, so it was pretty cool to walk down that alleyway.
Yeah.
And, like, the music is the same.
And, like, the title cards in front of you are giant.
Right.
Yeah. Same font. That was cool, too.
Yeah.
It's like you're in the show.
Yeah, I got some great pictures of that one, too. And we got some sound bites. Nick got to get interviewed.
I did. They interviewed me. They said they're going to put me in their promo video. So you'll see my ugly mug answering questions.
It's proof we were actually there.
I wonder what the promo mug's going to be. I wonder if the promo video is going to be on Steam.
Oh, maybe.
Or they're going to have a commercial for it.
Or it'll be on their YouTube channel or something.
No.
Well,
not yet. Because I added it to my wish list on Steam, but it's not out yet. They don't have a release date.
For
that's the hard part.
But
too,
for
is
Steam,
like,
no, I think it is on Oculus. I think it is out.
Oh really?
Let me.
So I thought it, here,
Jamie.
Pull it up.
Pull up what? In like
Peaky Blinders.
So game. There's a game I really want to play. It's on my wish list. It's called Gal Guardians or something like that.
Yeah.
Yep. Gal Guardians.
It's
Demon
a it's a
something.
It's a Castlevania style game. But there was only four monitors, and it was packed all day long.
Yeah, it was pretty full. Yeah, see, available now on MetaQuest and Pico 4.
Oh yeah, see, it's available. But you gotta have a
Quest.
Like, that's the thing, is like, I don't know if I would buy a VR set.
It's not bad, it's only $400 now. They lowered the price.
Well, you gotta get the MetaQuest too. If you're gonna buy one,
that's
buy the
$400.
Oh, it is?
Yeah,
they lowered the price.
You buy the best one. I had an Oculus Rift, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. And I mean, I guess you can take what I say with a grain of salt, because you saw me today, Marcus. I zoned into every single game that I played.
Yeah, yeah.
But
you should.
But for me, with my experience with my Rift, literally, I put it on thinking I will only play an hour, and it did not feel like very long, and my phone buzzed, and it was my alarm for work in the morning.
Holy shit. So,
like, it just, I don't know what it is. After you play VR for a while, the time just, like, it literally just built, because I was playing Super Hot, which is, if
Super
you
Hot?
Know,
oh, yeah, yeah,
Super
yeah.
Hot, yeah.
That
Super Hot
cool.
In VR is so much fun.
I bet.
Like, it is
the
it's so great. So it's playing Super Hot, and it didn't, and there's no time or anything. It didn't feel like that long. So, I thoroughly enjoy VR. There are some games that get me kind of motion sick, but I think it is worth it. Some
right.
people say it's just kind of a gimmick or whatever, but I think you can game on it hard enough to where it's worth it if you are in the mindset for it. You
right.
know, like,
agreed.
And to share with friends. If you get one set and or if you get one headset, you know, and you invite five people over here.
Yeah, you can have a lot of fun.
Yeah.
Definitely. I'm tired now. Well, I'm preaching in the choir.
Same. Yep.
What?
I'm pretty tired.
Tired?
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll go upstairs and chill for a bit. Driggsy just messaged me. He says, yo, are you going to be here tomorrow? That's
yeah.
going to be great. Oh, yeah, you look like you're getting tired.
I am more tired.
Coffee up, son.
Yeah, I might have
it's
espresso martini.
We're going to Howl at the Moon for PAX
GDP
party.
I can't order an espresso martini after busting his balls about the fucking...
Oh, no, dude. Dude, if you order an espresso martini,
I'll just ask for a coffee.
Or Starbucks right there. Hey, man, can I order some food?
Yeah.
I'm going to do... I'll do the chicken BLT.
On the side, no french fries?
Yeah, that's fine. No, I'll do fries.
Anybody else?
Can I do the burger, please? Medium? And can I do a Caesar salad for a side? Thank you.
Can I get an order of the fries? Truffle fries? Yeah, the truffle fries.
Thank you.
Yeah. Yeah, that's it.
Can I do another Stella and a water? That's a book. Thank you.
And I'll do a Whirlpool. You're
can I get a Whirlpool too? Yeah.
I don't want you to be afraid of water.
No. This was really good.
I didn't make it. I made her make it.
Oh.
It's a power.
Well, it was good,
wow.
But.
Yeah,
no, I'll take a beer. Thanks.
He said he's going to Howl at the Moon for the PAX GPT party. And then he's going to the XSET party.
Oh, I got an invitation for that.
XSET? Yeah, we all have. That's the thing I got us into for free.
We already have.
We're on the guest list.
Yeah, we're on the guest
list. Where's that at?
11 minutes down the road. Walking.
Oh, okay. That's not too bad.
and I would say it's a, like, it was a good first day.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, so we saw a Miles Morales controller.
Oh, really?
It was dope.
Oh, yeah, it was.
And they wanted $160
really cool.
for it. Wasn't modded, had no pot paddles, no trigger.
It was simply painted.
It was just painted for $160. I was like, dude, that's a waste.
100%. I want to mod it with the paddles underneath.
Yes.
Oh, I think I forgot to tell you. Did you see at that one, I forget, I think it was Vega, at the one booth that we were at, did you see the limited edition Castlevania collection that they had? It was like literally, it was sealed. It was the Castlevania collection, and then they had a bunch of like old Star Wars games also sealed.
Oh, at the...
Did you see that booth? I think it was Vega.
I'm not sure.
It was the same booth that had the Miles Morales controller, but it was it was closer to the right where they had
Oh, no, I didn't see that.
We'll have to go back tomorrow and check that out if it's still there.
Yeah, they had a lot of cool booths.
Also, shout out to the board and dice game community because their section genuinely impressed me.
Yeah.
I mean, the solid wood gaming tables, all the different shaped dice.
Those were amazing.
It was super cool.
Yeah.
Tomorrow, hopefully, I'll win 10 1v1s in a row in CSGO.
Oh, yeah.
And win some cool stuff.
That's cool.
See, while I'm not a traditional sports fan, I really do enjoy hockey.
Hockey's cool.
Football, not so much. Soccer, golf. Tennis is cool. Basketball's great. Hockey, thoroughly enjoy as well.
Yeah. We could probably stop this, huh? Marcus?
Got anything else to say, Marcus?
Yeah, I always have a lot.
You know, the experience I had playing different games just makes me feel how much being locked into one game may not be like the right way to play games. And I can understand where like variety gaming is fun, but it may not be ideal. But there's so many games out there that I just don't play because I'm busy playing a game where maybe I should be. You know what I mean? I don't know. For me, I think that realizing that there's other games to play makes me want to just play them and not just be married to one, even with limited time.